Well, this viral video from Christmas Eve is pretty outrageous. It shows a New York City police officer defending himself against five homeless men in the subway. The officer has been praised for his restraint, actually. He used only his baton to fend off the five attackers despite being on his own. But what led to the officer, Syed Ali, being put in this situation in the first place? Could this attack have been prevented? Here now to weigh in, Joseph Imperatrice of Blue Lives Matter and New York City GOP Councilman Joe Borelli. Good to see you both.
Good morning. Good morning.
Joe, let's talk first of all from the political aspect, and when you think of the city council and other local officials here, what policies do you think have led to the ability of folks to just be going after police
officers? Well, in this case, you're seeing the culmination of two bad policies New York City implemented over the de Blasio administration. First, the fact that we don't any longer prosecute fare beaters, people that jump turnstiles and allow people like this to just occupy subway platforms and harass people. The second is that we no longer comply with federal officials. One of the people that were arrested in this incident had two ICE detainers and had been arrested previous times for forcible touching, you know, real crimes.
Right.
And the New York City government just didn't comply with these detainers.
Well, I grew up around this city, and I remember a time when Rudy Giuliani was the mayor, and he had sort of the broken windows philosophy. You go after the small crimes that Joe was just talking about, and you can try to snuff out some of the bigger crimes. As somebody who defends law enforcement, what are police officers up against now when Mayor de Blasio, as I understand, he's not going after small marijuana offenses in the city, not going after fare jumpers, as Joe just said. That leaves the police officers as lame ducks sometimes.
This officer was presented with a terrible situation. It could have been a lot worse. If he used, quote unquote, too much force, he'd be on the front paper and be villainized.
Mm-hmm.
If he had his butt handed to him and he was in the hospital or he got killed, he would have been a hero on the front page of the paper. And he made all of us proud by the way he acted. His training kicked in. He did it to a T. Now, there's two things here. Number one, it's stopping the small crimes. Go out there, affect them, get these people out of the subway system so that these potential situations won't be going on.
Mm-hmm.
Two is have law enforcement work with ICE agents, because like the councilman said, you have guys who have these retainers who shouldn't be here in the first place.
Sure.
You saw this in California with Officer Singh that was killed right after Christmas night with an illegal immigrant. If these individuals are not here in the first place, they can't hurt anybody. So we need to put the politics aside. Here you have Nancy Pelosi over in Hawaii, you know, with a smile on her face. Obviously, she doesn't care. Her family isn't under attack, but my blue family is, and we need to do something. We need to fix it now.
You mentioned Officer Singh. We've talked about him this morning. We're going to talk about him a lot more as we go through the program, but he certainly is not alone, sadly. And let's go through the numbers. Officers killed in the line of duty in 2018, it was up sharply from 2017. 47 officers killed in the line of duty so far in 2018. Shot and killed. Joe, how do you do something to stop this?
Look, we see a nationwide war on police where the value of our police officers is not taken as seriously as it once was. And sadly, we also see the rise of Democratic politicians running New York City, running cities around the country.
Mm-hmm.
Seattle, we have $1 billion a year spent on homeless services. The result is more homelessness, more crime. In Hempstead, a town overrun by MS-13 gangbangers,
right,
the solution was to have a gun buyback of toy guns. These are politicians that have their head in the sand when it comes to how to deal with real problems, real crimes in their community.
Joe, real quick, what's your message as we head into the new year?
We need to respect one another, of course, but officers need to be able to do their job every single day, especially here. You see officers killed in the line of duty, and there is a constant war on cops. And if officers are allowed to do their job, and we're able to go back to the broken windows policy with the small stuff, which will lead to the big stuff stopping, I think a lot of cops will be a lot safer.
Joe, we appreciate you both coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you.